Yesterday, the worst-kept secret in gaming was finally revealed, the Super Mario 35th Anniversary Celebration. We of course learned about all the things happening for Mario turning 35 years old, and of course we made a video on it, but since then, there have been a ton of new details about these upcoming games and items that not many people are really talking about. So today I wanted to do a deep dive into everything we know about things like the Super Mario 3D All-Stars Collection, Super Mario 3D World Plus, and much more, because while most of it is good, some of it you might not like. What's going on, guys? I'm RGT85. If this is your first time on the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. But without any further ado, let's talk about the Super Mario 35th Anniversary Collection and everything we've learned so far since the announcement. So the first thing we're going to talk about is the Super Mario Game & Watch. Now really, this was just something completely out of left field. I don't think many people anticipated ever playing the original Super Mario Brothers on a Game & Watch, but here we are. 2020 is a wild time. Now we did learn that this was coming out this year, but we didn't know the price point of it. And that was something that a lot of people were skeptical about because, well, Nintendo tends to overprice things. But shockingly, I think this is a pretty good price for the Super Mario Game & Watch. This will be retailing for $49.99, which I think is very, very reasonable. We actually learned about the battery life of the Super Mario Game & Watch as well, which will give you about 8 hours of play time on a single charge. So once again, you know, that's actually pretty good. Of course, this includes Super Mario Brothers and Super Mario Brothers The Lost Level, along with a Game & Watch inspired Mario thing. Now, actually, when you're not playing the game or trying to save the Mushroom Kingdom, there's an included digital clock as well. As time passes, you will check out one of 35 different animations during this time frame, and it includes some guest appearances from Mario's friends and his foes from various Mario video games. So honestly, I think the Super Mario Game & Watch is really cool. I went ahead and signed up for the list of BestBuy.com to be alerted when this is available for pre-order, because I think this is going to be a pretty interesting thing. It's obviously going to be a heavy collector's item. I'm sure there's already idiots on eBay scalping this thing, but some cool additional details about it. Next up, I want to talk about the Mario Kart Live Home Circuit. Now, once again, much like the Super Mario Game & Watch, this was completely out of left field. I don't think anyone was ever anticipating something like this. There have been rumors of a new Mario Kart game. Of course, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe came out on the Nintendo Switch, but I don't think anyone was anticipating a game like this because, well, it's not really a game. It's more of an interactive experience that you can use your Nintendo Switch as a controller for. Now, this will be retailing for $99.99. It includes various track pieces, Mario in a cart, and Luigi in a cart. So you're getting a decent value for this, obviously. You know, the technology within the carts themselves that is going to be used for the AR technology is probably something that's a bit more expensive than things like a piece of plastic for Mario and, of course, the track pieces themselves. So I think that's fine. I would assume that they're going to sell individual racers down the road, much like they did with things like Amiibo. So I think that's going to be an absolute cash cow from Nintendo. You know, they're obviously going to have people like Bowser, maybe even people like, you know, Link, who was included in DLC for Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. So really, the sky is the limit with who they're going to include within these additional figures for Mario Kart Live Home Circuit. Now, when you're playing in 150cc mode, you get about 1.5 hours of constant race time. So obviously, you know, with something like this, you're not going to play it for hours and hours on end. I mean, maybe you are or something like that, but about an hour and a half, you know, I think that's decent. I would have liked to have seen it be a bit more. It's obviously going to be something that's going to take a while to charge. For a full charge, it's supposedly about 3 hours, so that's something you're going to want to keep in mind when you're playing with this. Now, the software that's included for Mario Kart Live Home Circuit is only going to be available via download, meaning that there won't be a cartridge inside of the box or anything like that, which I think is a bit strange. You know, maybe it's just a cost-cutting measure. Obviously, as someone who likes to collect actual physical video games, that's a bit of a disappointment, but not the biggest deal in the world. And of course, this is going to use heavy AR technology in order to work, and I think this AR technology actually looks really cool. I'm definitely interested to see how this ends up turning out with the final product. I have carpets in my condo, so I won't really be able to use it. I might just go into like the parking lot and set up something, because I am interested to see how this does translate when you're playing it, you know, controlling it with your Nintendo Switch and viewing it from a different perspective with the AR technology. Really cool stuff, and it almost makes me wonder what else Nintendo can try to do with using the Nintendo Switch just as a controller with real-world elements. Of course, Super Mario 3D World Plus was announced that will be including Bowser's Fury and will be releasing in the early part of 2021 for the Nintendo Switch, meaning that, well, really besides Xenoblade Chronicles X, there aren't many exclusives left on the Nintendo Wii U. But we did learn some interesting stuff about Super Mario 3D World Plus because it seems like there's a lot of revisions being done to this version of the game. Now, according to Game Explain, the Switch version of the game appears to have faster gameplay at about roughly 20 to 30% faster than the previous version of the game that released on the Nintendo Wii U. There's also some new moves that are included, such as a Mario Odyssey style mid-air dive that you can use when you are playing the game. It seems like the roll in the game has more impact as well as far as being used as an attack in the game. And what's really cool is that Bowser's Fury seems to be like an open area segment for the game, so who really knows how much additional content is going to be included with Bowser's Fury. Some people were thinking that Bowser's Fury was just essentially going to be the same levels from the game, just with harder difficulty, but I think this is actually going to be a pretty sizable expansion to Super Mario 3D World by including in Bowser's Fury, and you're actually going to have new levels and new missions to do, and just new stuff to do in general when it comes to this game. But really, the biggest addition to Super Mario 3D World Plus has to be the fact that the game now features true online multiplayer. Now, you might remember when Super Mario 3D World originally came out on the Nintendo Wii U, that was something that a lot of people were asking for, either via an update, because the original Super Mario 3D World only featured local multiplayer. Well, now Super Mario 3D World Plus will feature full online multiplayer, meaning that you can play with other people, and I think that is a huge addition to this game. Now, yes, you're probably going to have to use the stupid Nintendo Switch voice chat app in order to talk to people in the game, but you know what? Finally including online multiplayer in this game, I think, is a big win, and really, this is a game I have no problem paying the full $60 for when it releases, because they're adding in additional content. They've obviously added in things like smoother gameplay, new moves, the whole Bowser's Fury thing, and the online multiplayer really is just the cherry on the ice cream sundae known as Super Mario 3D World. So I'm definitely stoked for Super Mario 3D World Plus. I think this is going to be a great game for the Nintendo Switch, and all these new additions that they're adding are really very key to this. And the final game we of course have to talk about is Super Mario 3D All-Stars, the game that supposedly didn't exist. RGT was just making it up for clicks and was lying to everyone. I tried to tell you guys, like, I don't want to lie to you guys. I want to steer you in the right direction. Yes, sometimes I'm wrong about things, but I was very confident about this. So believe in me, trust me, I am a friend to you. I am a friend to you. But of course, we learned about Super Mario 3D All-Stars. The three games included in the collection are Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and Super Mario Galaxy. Now, of course, since then, we have gotten additional details about all of these games, so I just wanted to share this information with you guys. Starting things out with Super Mario 64, redone textures are being added into this game. Some eagle-eyed people over on Reddit saw that some of the textures have actually been improved upon for this version of the game. It was mostly with Mario's cap and the little M signal on it, but I think that's very cool and shows very positive things for this game. Now, something that I personally am not a fan of is the fact that this game does not support widescreen. It's only in 4x3 mode, which I think is really bizarre to me. Like, it's not the end of the world or anything like that, but I would have loved to have seen widescreen support 16x9 with this game, because you're obviously making all the textures in HD. You're redoing textures as well. Why couldn't you have just added in widescreen support? Now, as far as the resolution of the game will be running at 960 by 720 in both handheld and TV modes. I do think the game looks absolutely fantastic. I do wonder what other sort of textures have been cleaned up in this game, but it's definitely a bit disappointing to me personally that they did not include widescreen mode. I will get over it, but maybe some people won't be able to. Now, when it comes to Super Mario Sunshine, we learned some additional details about that, and before I even get into these details, let me say I think this game looks fantastic. This HD version of the game looks absolutely beautiful. Just looking at that trailer from yesterday, like, I'm not even a Super Mario Sunshine fan, but I'm definitely looking forward to playing this game just because of how good it looks, and I really hope they fixed up the controls. Now, as far as the resolution is with Super Mario Sunshine, you're getting 1920 by 1080p in TV mode and 1280 by 720 in handheld mode. So basically 1080p in docked mode, 720p in handheld mode, which I think is very acceptable for this game. Of course, that's the max that the Nintendo Switch handheld mode can do as of right now is 720p. But something, once again, that's kind of interesting, that is sort of, you know, a weird omission, is the fact that there's no GameCube controller support for this version of Super Mario Sunshine. Now, of course, you have GameCube controller support for things like Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Why would the GameCube game not have GameCube controller support? Some people are upset by this. I'm just hoping that they have, you know, redone the controls and made them controls tight enough to where I won't even worry about the GameCube controller. But once again, this is sort of a strange omission to not have GameCube controller support for Super Mario Sunshine. And when it comes to Super Mario Galaxy, we learned some additional details about that too. That game will be running up to 1920 by 1080p in docked mode, 1280 by 720p in handheld mode. Once again, it seems like this game is going to have a variable sort of resolution. I'm not quite sure how that's going to work. This information was floating around the internet though, so I just wanted to bring it to your guys' attention. At the maximum, it'll run at 1080p in docked mode, 720p in handheld mode. I don't know how much variables there will be within that. Hopefully it's mostly a, you know, 1080p or 720p depending on how you're playing it experience, but I did want to mention that. And of course, one of the big questions was with Super Mario at Galaxy where how the motion controls were going to be handled, because obviously there's something called a Nintendo Switch Lite where you can't detach the Joy-Cons, and they're actually going to be handled in a few different ways. First off, the motion controls are completely optional, which I think is a very good thing because some people just don't like motion controls. I thought they were harmless enough in Super Mario Galaxy on the Wii, but it's nice to not have to worry about motion controls, and it kind of shows that maybe Nintendo could do a Skyward Sword, but that's a video for another day. Now, Nintendo did clarify by saying that if you wanted to use the pointer functionality, you will have to use the motion controls, and that's for docked use. Obviously, you'll have to use your Joy-Cons. If you're actually playing in handheld mode, though, the pointer functionality has been remapped to the touchscreen, so you can simply touch the screen to use that pointer functionality if you have a Nintendo Switch Lite, so I think that's a very, very good thing. Now, one thing that is worth noting is that all of these games in the Super Mario 3D All-Stars collection can be played with a Pro controller. So I think that's a good option to have for a lot of people. I love my Pro controller, so not having to worry about Joy-Con use for this is definitely a very good thing. But finally, there's been one very, very strange thing about the Super Mario 3D All-Stars, and of course, Super Mario 35, which is that Battle Royale-style game that is being developed by the people who did Tetris 99, is the somewhat limited availability of this, because, well, it really just doesn't make sense. It seems like Super Mario 3D All-Stars will only be available till the end of March 2021, along with Super Mario 35. So it's like, what do you mean by that? Obviously, a physical edition getting a limited run is one thing. They did that with the 25th anniversary collection on the Nintendo Wii, but it seems like it's going to be both the physical and the digital editions of Super Mario 3D All-Stars and Super Mario 35 are only going to be available till the end of March, and then boom, that's it. And a lot of people are questioning this. Is Nintendo going to release these as an individual thing where you can get all the individual games from 3D All-Stars and just pay a whatever price for it, you know, $20 a pop or something like that? But really, that's just kind of strange to me because, you know, the Nintendo 64 and GameCube and really the Nintendo Wii aren't included in any sort of Nintendo Switch Online services. So unless they are going to that sort of, you know, individual price point for these games, what's going to happen to these games? Like, it's just a very, very bizarre thing. And it's something that I definitely think Nintendo needs to clarify, because really, if these games are only going to be available to download and play until March of 2021, and then beyond that, you don't have a chance to either buy this game in the case of Super Mario 3D All-Stars or even play this game in the case of Super Mario 35, like, that's just absolutely bizarre to me and really just makes no sense. Now, I did pre-order a physical edition of Super Mario 3D All-Stars from Best Buy. I am pre-ordering the digital version as well. I probably will just leave the sealed the physical copy sealed just to have it in my collection, but still, it's a very strange thing, and I think it's something that Nintendo needs to clarify. And if they are going to go this route where you can't get it after March, you need to say if you're going to be able to get these games in any way, shape, or form beyond March, unless I guess it's just a big surprise about more consoles coming to the Switch Online service. Nintendo's just so weird, you never really know what to expect from them. Alright, so that is all of the new information we have gotten from yesterday's Super Mario 35th Anniversary Nintendo Direct presentation. I hope you guys enjoyed all this information. If you did, be sure to share it around with your friends, let them know some of the clarifications on things, some of the things like price point, resolution, what you're going to be able to do with these games, because I found this to be very fascinating. And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you are new new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. Welcome to all the new subscribers from yesterday's video. Like, that video did very, very well. And yes, there were a few mistakes in there. Look, I thought I got it. Like, I had woken up at like 9:15 and people were blowing up my phone and they were like, they announced the Super Mario 35th thing. I didn't even shower. I had like a morning cigarette and I was just like, okay, time to get to work. So that, yeah, that you know, I did clean up the video a little bit in YouTube's editor, so I'm sorry for that. This video will be edited tighter. And as always, guys, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Later.